it was a commission for me and the Ottawa Symphony for a regular symphonic concert. And the subject was very interesting for me because it's a woman. I think the title is a bit deceiving because it says Adieu Robert Schumann. You think it's going to be in French, and then I start out singing one of his last German songs. And then it is the diary of Clara Schumann about her husband going mad and dying. Clara Schumann was a Clara Wieck. She was a very famous pianist, and she was a very strong personality in her own right. And this was a great love affair. And it's very interesting in the beginning where it says, when she went to the asylum for the first time to see him, and Brahms went with me. And we know the attachment of her attachment for Brahms as well. So it's a very personal thing.
Did you work on this particular composition from the start together?
Well, Murray is a wonderful composer in the way that he knows my voice very well. And when he wrote this, he wrote it for my capabilities. What's interesting about Murray Schafer's work is that he said to me, you know, I could never be so egotistical to compose for Schumann, but I try to imagine myself as Schumann going mad. And that's why he incorporated a bit of the Kreisleriana, some of the songs, sometimes distorted music of, and then of course he put it all together and added his own music orchestration as well.
There is a piano sequence in the middle of the work, juxtaposed with the word angels.
Ah, yes. Well, this is, of course, the diary is the exact diary by Clara Schumann. And it's a point where she says, last night, after we had been in bed for some time, Robert suddenly asked me to listen. And he said that angels were dictating to him. He honestly believed that when he wrote that da 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 da, that's not one of his great pieces of music, Schumann, but he honestly believed that angels had dictated that piece to him. It was his form of going mad. He did go mad probably in those days. Most people went mad probably from syphilis. And it was a lot of hallucinatory passages in the piece. And he was in and out of the asylum all the time. And it was just tragic for this woman to watch this great composer and this great human being, this wonderful love affair, go mad. Well, there's one point in the diary, and it's not in the songs, but where he was so worried about what would happen to his wife after he was gone, that he went across a little bridge and he took off his wedding ring and threw it into the water because he felt that was cutting himself off from her and that she should go on with her life. It was a very, very interesting marriage.
Yeah. Is there a direct reference in the music to Clara and to Robert?
Yes. Murray Schafer borrowed something that Schumann himself did. Yeah, Schumann used to write little messages to his wife in many of his songs. And he would write C-A-O, and every time I sing Clara, I sing Clara, which is a C-A, and Robert, he wrote himself with a B-E, I think it is. And but he did this during his lifetime, he did this very often. And after all, Clara Wieck was a great pianist. She championed very much of his music. And in a time when doing, avant-garde music was not very popular, but she believed so much in his music. And I thought that was a charming thing to do, to put this little code in much of the music that has. And when I sing songs now, I look for, because until I found that out, I wasn't aware of it. And now I find it in many of the songs that he put this little secret code so that she would understand it. It was a love song written for her.
Well, you mentioned the asylum and the particularly difficult time that Schumann had towards the end of his life.
Yes.
Schafer seems to use various very contrasting moods. There is also interesting instruments, unusual instrumentation of Schafer.
Yes, and dissonance. He starts a progressive movement and then he distorts it as a person, subtly going into hallucination. And it was interesting because like many people who go mad, they hear a certain sound. And with Schumann, it was an A. And at the very end of the piece, I thought it was wonderful the way he did that, because he reduces after Schumann has died. And Clara Schumann says she laid some flowers on his head and departed. And just before she says the last line, I am all alone, he reduces the orchestra in the tonality, and then only the trumpet plays the A, which must have driven him mad, you know, to hear this A all the time, as a composer, to not get the sound out of his head, ringing probably in the head.
I'm first came to the asylum. Asylum, how bitter the a terrible change. write something down. Not much. Then he would listen you.
alt Gras ich am Rhein, bald hab ich ein Schätzchen, bald bin ich allein. Was hilft mir das Rasen, wenn sich hier nicht schreit? Was hilft mir ein Schätzchen, bei mir nicht
Liebes Kind, morgen wollen
dich soll, gell, dich soll, immer weiter.